science for. Objectives. Describe what is water cycle. Identify and describe its importance of water cycle. Let us have a short review first about the past lesson. Are you ready, kids? Let's go!
Water can be obtained from a variety of places. It can originate from public or private sources. It may originate from either a small or large body of water. Clouds are the source of rainwater. There are three major water bodies. The type of water is determined by the source: seawater, freshwater, and groundwater. Seawater contains plenty of salt. It also called hard water. Freshwater is called surface water. It does not contain salt. It comes from rain, and for cold or icy places, it comes from snow. Water is very important to all life forms. Water is one of the most vital elements on the planet. Water is needed for survival of the plants and animals. There would be no life on Earth if there was no water. Do you know what is water cycle? How does water cycle affect our lives? Did you know the importance of water cycle? What are the processes involved in water cycle? I know you already have idea about it. But let us check first if you really do by answering this activity. Directions. Read the sentences carefully. Write your answers on your notebook. You will be given 5 seconds to answer each item. Number 1. It is the path that all water follows as it moves around the planet. A. Life cycle. B. Water cycle. C. Plant cycle. D. Food cycle. Your timer starts now. Time's up! The correct answer is letter B. Good job! Number 2. It is the process where water is released from clouds in the form of rain, freezing rain, sleet, snow, or hail. It is the primary connection in the water cycle that provides for the delivery of atmospheric water to the earth. A. Precipitation. B. Infiltration. C. Condensation. D. Evaporation. Your timer starts now. Time's up! The correct answer is letter A. Precipitation. You got right. Good luck. Number 3. It is the process by which water changes from a liquid to a gas or vapor. It occurs when sunlight warms the surface of the water. A. Precipitation. B. Infiltration. C. Condensation. D. Evaporation. Your timer starts now. Time is up. The correct answer is letter D. Evaporation. Number 4. It is a process in which water vapor, gaseous form, in the air changes into liquid water when it comes in contact with the cooler surface. A. Infiltration. B. Evaporation. C. Condensation. D. Precipitation. Your timer starts now. Time is up. The correct answer is letter C. Condensation. Number 5. It is the process by which underground surface enters the soil. A. Precipitation. B, evaporation. C, condensation. D, infiltration. Your timer starts now. Time is up. The correct answer is letter D, infiltration. Did you get all the correct answers, kids? That's awesome. I'm pretty sure that you are now ready for our lesson today. Kids, do you know that water cycle is the path that all water follows as it moves around the earth in different states? Liquid water is found in the oceans, rivers, lakes, and even underground. Water cycle has four main processes: evaporation, condensation, precipitation, and infiltration. Today, we will learn all of this and you will have clear understanding how water cycle take place. Let's begin. Kids, do you know how evaporation occurs? Now, let's explore about this. Evaporation is the process by which water changes from a liquid to a gas or vapor. Evaporation occurs when sunlight warms the surface of the water. The heat from the sun makes the water molecules move faster and faster, until they move so fast and they escape as a gas. Evaporation is a very important part of the water cycle. Heat from the sun or the solar energy powers the evaporation process. It soaks up moisture from soil in a garden as well as the biggest ocean and lakes. The water level will decrease as it is exposed to the heat of the sun. Condensation. It is the process by which water vapor in the air is changed into liquid water. Condensation is crucial to the water cycle because it is responsible for the formation of clouds. When the water in the air comes into contact with the cold surface, it condenses to form water droplets. The reverse of condensation is evaporation reaction. Water molecules in the vapor form are arranged more randomly than in liquid water. As condensation occurs in liquid water forms from the vapor, the water molecules become more organized and heat is released into the atmosphere as a result. Kids, now that you already learned about the two processes, the evaporation and condensation, just remember that they are just exactly the opposite processes. Just hang on, because we will still have two more important processes involved the water cycle that we need to explore. They are precipitation and infiltration. The air is full of water, even if you can see it, higher in the sky where it is colder than at the land surface. Invisible water vapor condenses into tiny liquid water droplets, which are called clouds. Precipitation is water released from clouds in the form of rain, freezing rain, sleet, snow, or hail. It is the primary connection in the water cycle that provides for the delivery of atmospheric water to the earth. Most precipitation falls as rain. Infiltration is the process by which underground surface enters the soil. Infiltration is the process of water entry into the soil through the earth's surface. The water at the soil surface can originate from rain, snow melt, or anthropogenic activities. Groundwater begins as precipitation. Anywhere in the world, a portion of the water that falls is rain and snow infiltrate into the surface soil and rock. How much infiltrate depends greatly on the number of factors. Kids, now you finally learn about the four important processes involved in water cycle. Did you learn new facts about them? Can you relate this process to simple activities at home? Just like observing how water evaporates when you boil the water in your kettle in a high temperature. Amazing, right? Now, let me ask you, why is water cycle important? Would life be the same if one of the processes in water cycle is not present? What do you think will happen? The importance of water cycle. The water cycle is an extremely important process because it enables the availability of water for all living organisms and regulates weather patterns on our planet. If water didn't naturally recycle itself, we would run out of clean water, which is essential to life. The water cycle is important to all life on Earth for many reasons. All living organisms require water, and the water cycle describes the process of how water moves through the planet. How water moves through the planet Earth is truly unique in its abundance of water. Water is necessary to sustain life on Earth and helps tie together the Earth's lands, ocean, and atmosphere into an integrated system. Do you know that climate change has an impact in water cycle? Did you understand our discussion? Now let's have a short recap in our lesson. What are the four processes in water cycle? First is evaporation, condensation, precipitation, and infiltration. So the importance of water cycle is an extremely important process because it enables the availability of water for all living organisms and regulates weather patterns on our planet. If water didn't naturally recycle, we would run out of clean water, which is essential to life. Directions. Label the missing processes of water cycle as shown in the drawing. Write your answer on a separate sheet of paper. You have 30 seconds to answer this activity. This will be the end of our lesson. Goodbye.